We have major breaking news right now.
The Department of Justice reveals that they will appoint a special counsel.
This announcement takes this investigation to another level.
On May 17, 2017, Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein appointed Robert Mueller as special counsel. Here's how his investigation into Russian interference in the U.S. election and any potential coordination between the Trump campaign and Moscow unfolded. In July, 2 months after the special counsel's appointment, FBI agents executed a search warrant on the Virginia home of former Trump campaign chairman Paul Manafort, seizing evidence and documents. Then in October, the special counsel charged Manafort and his longtime business partner Rick Gates, who also served on Trump's campaign, with crimes related to lobbying work they had done on behalf of pro-Russian Ukrainians from 2006 to 2015.
I think you're going to see a lot of pressure put on Paul Manafort in the next coming weeks. I suspect there's going to be other indictments as well.
That fall, Mueller surprised the country with two bombshell revelations. Former Trump foreign policy advisor George Papadopoulos pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI about his interactions with Russians and Russian intermediaries during the campaign. And Trump's former national security advisor, Michael Flynn, pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI about his conversations with the Russian ambassador during the presidential transition.
Flynn's plea is the latest and strongest indication that he may now be cooperating with special counsel Robert Mueller's investigation.
Flynn would go on to provide substantial assistance to prosecutors, sitting for at least 19 interviews. A few months later, in February, Mueller took aim at Russian interference efforts, indicting 13 Russian nationals and three Russian entities on charges of coordinating a massive social media campaign to interfere in the presidential election.
They established social media pages and groups to communicate with unwitting Americans. They also purchased political advertisements on social media networks. The Russians also recruited and paid real Americans to engage in political activities, promote political campaigns, and stage political rallies.
Soon after that indictment, Alex van der Zwaan, an associate of Manafort and Gates, pleaded guilty to lying to investigators about work he did with the two men on behalf of pro-Russian politicians in Ukraine. Just days later, Mueller charged Manafort and Gates with more crimes related to tax fraud and bank fraud, ramping up pressure on the two men. The following day, Gates pleaded guilty to two charges and agreed to cooperate with prosecutors. Manafort, who continued to maintain his innocence, was slapped with more charges in June, indicted alongside his longtime Russian business partner, Konstantin Kalimnik, for obstructing justice. Prosecutors allege that the two men tried to influence witness testimony ahead of Manafort's fall trial, a charge Manafort later pleaded guilty to. The special counsel has said Kalimnik had ties to Russian intelligence in 2016, a charge Kalimnik has denied. In July, another major indictment. Mueller charged a dozen Russian intelligence officers with hacking the computers of Democratic organizations and Hillary Clinton campaign associates and stealing thousands of emails, many of which were released by WikiLeaks in the weeks before the U.S. election.
Our government here has the names of this malware, X-Agent, X-Tunnel. So it's clear that we have very good capabilities and that the FBI and our intelligence folks have been looking at this for quite some time.
Not long after, Manafort's first trial began in Virginia. And Gates, his former business associate, testified against him. Ultimately, a jury convicted Manafort on 8 counts of fraud. A month later, just before Manafort's second trial was set to begin in Washington, he pleaded guilty to 2 federal crimes and agreed to cooperate with the special counsel's office. However, a judge later threw out his plea agreement when prosecutors determined that Manafort had lied about issues material to the special counsel's investigation. Then in November, Trump's former attorney Michael Cohen pleaded guilty to lying to Congress about a Trump Tower Moscow deal he negotiated during the campaign. In a court filing, the special counsel revealed that negotiations over the Russian real estate deal were ongoing through June of 2016, after Trump had secured enough support to become the Republican nominee.
No, he's lying about a project that everybody knew about. I decided ultimately not to do it. There would have been nothing wrong if I did do it.
In January, Mueller charged another Trump associate. Roger Stone was indicted for lying to Congress about his conversations regarding WikiLeaks.
I will plead not guilty to these charges. I will defeat them in court.
In total, 6 Trump associates were charged in the probe. four of them accused of lying about their contacts with Russians and Russian intermediaries during the campaign and transition. More than two dozen Russians were also charged with crimes related to interfering in the U.S. election. But because the U.S. doesn't have an extradition treaty with Russia, most are never expected to face trial.